Hello there. Welcome back to another video of my sword Nuzlocke. And here I am, once again. I ran into some problems when trying to complete the previous episode. So, here I am once again, going through parts of the game that I unfortunately could not fully progress through. Anyways, here's Kabu speaking. Thank you for helping him with the training to me on this day. So we'll get a full skin. The way of a cock will hold up work. We were getting in this way, we're trying to cheer it on. Still, you did a number on us in that Pokemon battle, so it's time for Team Yell to scarp up and give a morale boost somewhere. Cheering is one thing, but one shouldn't get in the way of one's work. That's Kabu. Man, he's wicked. No wonder he's the fire type gym leader. Ah. You're the trainers and just melee and open wrist level, right? I'm just training right up to the last moment so that I can guarantee a perfect match for an issue challenges. I specialize in fire type Pokemon and the wood types that you get one guy wanna know what you are. Perfect opponents to train against. Go ahead, unless it's getting late. Just go straight well. Once you get out of this mine, you'll reach Motostoke. Get Goose to the hotel and make sure you're both in top condition. Come on, Kako, time for you to head on home to home. Make sure you get this safely. Couldn't be on fire tomorrow. I remember Lee talking about Kabu. He said that a lot of gym leader challenges give up because they just can't beat Kabu. Man, now I'm getting all fired up too. Well, let's follow him then. Stop in at Buddha Drop Inn for the night. Okay. That's Kako from before. Guess he must have been on Jungle. I've heard about Pokéjobs. Pokéjobs by now, right? I do. Of course you do. Now, Cream Cracker, I'm for the Buddha Drop Inn and some sleep. Come tomorrow, but that fight gym leader probably better be ready. Because I'll be coming for him. Motostoke Outskirts. Anyways, my encounter is going to be a little strange. I mean, we have some Pokemon that are already here. We can use, like, for example, the coffin. Which can get us glaring amazing. And Sudowoodoo has, like, a base that's over 410, so it's not really a priority of some sort. There's also Noctowl, which, to be honest with you, wouldn't be that exciting. We're gonna get Nibidimp. I suppose it's not that bad. Then again, this Impidimp will be used to trade all the way at big tears. It's somewhere. All the way at Stone Side for Hatterene. Some Hatana. Anyways, where are my little great balls? 1, 2, 3. Caught that Impidimp. Let's go. Impidimp's data will be added to the Pokedex. Impidimp, wily Pokemon, type Dark Fairy, height 1'4", weight 12.1 pounds, storm battle 1. Through its nose, it sucks the emanations produced by people and Pokemon when they feel annoyed. It thrives off this negative energy. Yes. Calling this Impidimp. Just call him, call it Rascal. Because it's definitely a Rascal at this moment. Anyways, that would be a trade. For the trade all the way to Stone Side, so it's not really gonna count. I mean, maybe could have at some point. I'll PP up. You know, encounter. This will be my actual most aggressive skirt up. I'm sure I've caught a Scraggy before. That was just like in the previous area. No, not this time. Another impotent. I'm not gonna deal with this, unfortunately. This isn't gonna have a cut yet. It's a Poniard. I actually wanted to use a Poniard since the one that could be found here. Anyways, let's see how we do fare well against this one. This is a Pokemon who has moves that it resists. Hopefully it's your time to shine again, once again. Scary face. It doesn't really matter. Let's see, its attack is 39. Special attack isn't as high. It resists this. Yeah, to switch through two grass type moves. Alright, then it did nothing. We'll tackle. Anyways, gonna have to live with this. Torment being activated, or scary face. This will take a while. Please don't break this bracer leaf. Still enough to be throw Pokeballs at. Cut the Poniard. Definitely replace it with something right here. Dark Steel. Anyways. Poniard. Sharp Blade Pokemon. Type Dark Steel. Height 1'8", weight 22.5 pounds. Never battled one. It uses river stones to maintain the cutting edges of its blades covering its body. These sharpened blades allow it to bring down opponents. Yes. Let's see, it's a pawn at this moment. It's got blades. Some want to give it sort of well, blades can pierce someone. I'm gonna call you Pierce. Anyways, attack. Okay, this laser might not be good, but at least we got Defiant on this one. Furry Claw, Furry Cutter, Metal Claw, Torment, and Scary Face. It's not as for a box right now, but I might use it sometime. Anyways, let's continue. Sure thing. Madam Caroline. Got a yapper. Let's see, I'll send in Annalise for this. Roar, okay. Let's do something, I guess. I'll summon Pokemon once again. It doesn't go for Roar this time. And it goes for Roar again. Doing this until I'm just gonna keep doing this until it just doesn't use roar. And there's roar. Once again, how many times do you want to roar? Just let me send in the love brain, we continue. That Yamper someday. Just use his roar over and over again. Okay, at least it's not still to quick attack. Okay, this is nice. Okay, Spark. Always super effective, but I think a few more quick attacks should take it out. There's roar. And back to Timothy. Send CD Pound. Okay, that did so nice. One more pound should do it. This Yamper should stop being weird. It's just roaring. Every time I send it my Mudsdale, my best Pokemon suited for it is Swoobat. Nixon shouldn't really fare well, to be honest with you. But I think a few Nuzlocke should do it. Oh yeah, it's Psychic Flying, it's weak to Psychic. Oh my gosh. Fourth death! I forgot that it was part psychic type. And that Toxic doesn't have a good base at all at this moment. Looks like we have another fainted Pokemon. Also, I kind of forgot about this. I had a rock type here all the time. Nicholas. You're gonna have to do this for me. Confusion. I can actually confuse this time. Okay, broke out of the confusion, thank you. Huh. Apparently the battle was much tougher than I expected. We lost a second Pokemon. Fourth, actually.
Oh, you're like used to Pokemon battles.
Yes. But you were so annoying with that Yamper just roaring and you painting my Toxel. Hello, what's the listing? Fancy a scrap with Copa? I guess so. After all, you are considered a copper. We use considering cop the word origin of cop. Anyways. Waterfalls. I can't believe it. We lost another Pokemon. What am I gonna replace that talk so far? Got some Pokemon with you there. I think it's bang on too. At least that wasn't as tough, but Roaring Growlithe. Health better. One of these feathers are enough to make up for that battle loss. Supposed to head towards Butter Drop Inn, which is just around here. Anyways, we'll continue the story. And I'll show up with a Toxel replacement as soon as possible. Anyways, hope you liked the video. If you did, subscribe to support me, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.